effects into your busy schedule and smash your fitness goals. We all know we need to do it. We need to exercise. We want to exercise, but we don't always feel like exercising, or we haven't always got time to exercise. In today's fast-paced world, finding time to exercise can be a challenge. We've got our busy work schedules, family commitments, numerous responsibilities. It's easy for exercise to take a back seat. However, incorporating physical activity into your routine is crucial for maintaining good health and overall well-being and burning that fat and building that muscle. What I'll talk through in this video is how we can explore effective strategies to help you fit exercise into your busy schedule, ensuring that your health remains your top priority without it taking over your life and becoming a habit. Plan ahead. Here we go. First option, making workouts a priority. You've got to prioritize your health and fitness. There shouldn't be anything more important to you in your life than your own health and fitness. What about my family? Absolutely. Of course, they're the most important thing. But if we're not healthy, we're not fit, we can't provide for our families, or we become a burden for our family if we get ill, or, you know, they have to look after us, these sort of things. Or it's just not fun. We want to keep up with the family, the kids, the dog. We want to be a role model as well. So we want to make sure it is your number one priority. And that's definitely more important than work. Yeah. So one of the most important steps is fitting exercise into your busy schedule. So we want to plan ahead, treat your workouts like any other important appointment, and prioritize them. Schedule your workouts in advance, put them in your calendar, planner, fitness app, share your calendar. Make sure you share your calendar with your work colleagues. Critical, yeah? In the calendar, they can't book meetings over at the top of it, and they need to know it's the most important thing. By setting specific times to your workouts, you're more likely to follow through, make them a regular part of your routine. And you've got to train other people to respect your fitness and exercise times as well. The more it's in there, the more they'll appreciate it, and they won't try and run over your critical time. Remember, your health should be just as important as any other commitments or tasks in your schedule. Good thing I recommend, train or exercise with your colleagues. Then they can't schedule meetings with you, yeah? Or put into practice things that you're building health and well-being activities into your day-to-day life with your work colleague. Get in touch with your HR department. Get them to get a health and well-being program up and running. So the health, fitness, exercise is an ingrained part of your whole work culture. Next piece of advice, optimize your time. We have time, we can put time into the calendar, but we can't put hours in the calendar, especially if it's during the middle of the day, or if it's during the first part of your day. You don't want to wake up at 4 a.m. or in the evening. We don't want to be having 2 or 3 hours after work in the gym when we could be at home with our family. So choose efficient workouts. Times can be limited, so it's essential to choose workouts that are efficient and effective. High intensity interval training is a good one from the cardio perspective. HIIT circuit training, these are good. You get more stuff done in a short amount of time, and it's challenging, which makes it fun. Bit of competition never hurts. So these options are really good. It's full body stuff. Short amount of time, smash it out, get it done. HIIT, probably tried it, short, sharp bursts of energy. This is good cardio, not just because it's short, sharp, to the point and quick, but also really gets your heart rate elevated into the burn zone. This is the zone where you're going to be burning fat and also pushing that muscle to deliver better results, strengthening that muscle, yeah. Circuit training, this involves performing a series of exercises in sequence. You target different muscle groups during the progress of the sequence. These maximize calorie burn. They provide cardiovascular and strength benefits simultaneously, making them ideal for busy schedules. This is my favorite. Supersets. Choose 1, 2, 3 or more challenge yourself exercises to do back to back to back to back. Don't spend long amounts of time resting between those sets. Push on, push on, and you'll be amazed how much you get done in a short amount of time. Next piece of advice, be flexible, adjust to unpredictable schedules. Yeah. Okay. We've got it as best as we can scheduled into our calendar. Guess what? Shit happens. Stuff gets in the way, stuff we can't avoid. Yeah. So it's unpredictable, our life. And sometimes our schedules don't go to plan. So it's important that you're flexible and willing to adjust your workout plans as you need. If you miss a planned workout, don't get discouraged. Remember, even a short workout is better than no workout at all. So break your exercise routine into smaller sessions throughout the day. This could work better for your schedule. So you might do a quick 15-minute workout during your lunch break, or take a brisk walk in the evening, or run the dog first thing in the morning. Adaptability is the key to fitting exercise into your lifestyle, yeah? Wake up earlier, embrace your morning workouts. This one I really like. Try it out, right? It's my top tip. If your scheduling permits, waking up earlier, fitting into your morning schedule, it could be an absolute game changer. It requires a bit of adjustment, especially if you're not a morning person initially. Starting your day with exercise boosts your energy levels. It enhances your mood, improves your mental clarity for the whole day. And by completing your workout first thing in the morning, you eliminate the risk of unpredictable, unexpected events derailing your plans later in the day. Additional morning exercise sets a positive tone for the rest of your day, increasing your motivation and your productivity. And it stops the exercise or your workout being on your mind all day going, oh, I've got to do it. I've got to do it later. Don't think I'm going to have time. And it avoids the guilt if you do miss it. First thing in the morning, nobody can mess with your schedule. Yeah, if you get up early enough, your boss can't call you. Your colleagues can't hassle you to have a meeting. Very smart way to train. Next up, utilize technology. Harness the power of apps and trackers. They are our friends. Use your smart devices. Use your Fitbits and Apple Watches. It's the digital age. Technology is a very valuable tool for fitting exercise into a busy schedule. Use your fitness apps, online workout programs to help with the flexibility and convenience. These apps have a wide range of workouts or of training plans. But also the main thing they'll provide is tracking. So progress tracking. You'll know exactly what you've done or you've not done. So if you're not having the results you want, have a look, download, have a look at your tracker, have a look at what you've done, what you've maybe not done enough of, and it will highlight it for you. It's a great way not of beating yourself up. It's a great way of going, this is an area that I struggle with and hence I need to do a bit more of. So using these trackers, they'll help monitor your daily activity levels and as well. So not just your actual activity through exercise, your step count, your non-exercise activity as well. And these all add up to extra fat burn, extra calorie burn. And these are the things that really will make a critical change as well. Also, having those visual reminders of your progress, it helps you stay motivated. And there's a bit of gamification involved with these devices as well. They'll help people, they'll give you a little nudge, you know, oh, you've only got another 100 steps to do, or you've only got that much more of your red circle to fill. Pushes you to finish off and finish strong. This one is also critical, really good one. This one, find a buddy that provides accountability and efficiency. So find a workout buddy. It really significantly impacts your ability to stay consistent and maximize the efficiency of your workout time. You've got someone that shares your goals. Make sure it is similar goals, not someone like, you know, you're starting to play tennis and you choose Roger Federer as your workout buddy. They're going to be enthusiastic, but you're going to get smashed. Equally, don't choose a five-year-old kid as your training partner. Unless it's your own son or daughter, in which case, yeah, they'll be easy on them. Don't be an overly competitive dad, but choose someone that's got like-minded goals, and it's going to help you keep you motivated, not discouraged. So that's critical, yeah? And they're going to help you stay committed to regular exercise. They create the accountability. You wake up in the morning and go, I cannot be bothered to train. But you go, my mate Dave's waiting at the gym for me. I can't let him down. Like vice versa, you will be their support partner as well. So you schedule your joint workouts. You push each other to work a bit harder. Bit of mutual support and motivation. And exercising with a buddy, it makes it much more fun and enjoyable. If you have a little bit of a yarn, you can be a bit more competitive and give each other a push. Let's not rest anymore. Let's keep moving onwards. So really good way of training. Next up, increase your NEAT, N-E-A-T, non-exercise activity thermogenesis, through incorporating activity into your daily life. These are calories burned through daily activities that are not deliberate exercise. Increasing your NEAT can be an effective way to fit exercise into your busy schedule without really realizing it. So look for opportunities to be active throughout the day always. Take the stairs instead of the lift, walk to work, cycle to work, and these sort of things. incorporate standing or walking meetings, just these small lifestyle changes, they all add up to contributing to your overall activity level. Without realizing it, and over the course of a day, a week, a month, a year, bang, you'll be there increasing the fitness, increasing your fat burn, keeping the waistline nice and trim. What else? Create a work challenge or lunchtime legends competition. So incorporating and encouraging a culture of health and fitness in your workplace have a really positive impact on everyone else's exercise habits. So consider initiating a work challenge or lunchtime legends competition where colleagues can participate in friendly fitness competitions, kick down the park, bit of a football league, touch footy league, something like that, running club, these sort of things. It fosters a supportive environment, which your boss will love, and encourages more colleagues to exercise, making them more understanding of the need to prioritize physical activity. So when you schedule a training session in and they go, oh, can I have a meeting? They go, oh, I'll respect that because we're all in the fitness mindset as well. Also adds an element of fun and camaraderie to the workplace. HR and your boss love this and your team loves this. So it's a really good thing to get involved with. Speak to your HR department to stump up a bit of welfare, wellness, cash. There's often some available to them to use, and it helps to have their employees fit. If you're fit, you're not going to spend as much time sit, which means you're going to be more productive. So have a check if you don't already have any sort of fitness or wellness event set up, or a well-being committee, that sort of thing. Really helps to build the fitness corporation. So proper planning, time optimization, flexibility, supportive technology, getting a workout buddy, increasing your NEAT, and fostering a healthy, focused workplace environment. These are all the things that we're going to use to be able to help to prioritize our health and well-being. We know we need to. It's crucial for our long-term success and happiness. So by implementing these strategies, you can create a sustainable exercise routine that harmoniously integrates with your busy lifestyle. Remember, every small step toward the healthier you is a step in the right direction. Need a bit more assistance with your health, fitness, fat burns? I can help. Have a look in the comments below. There's a few strategies, a few options, and a few resources that can help you achieve your health and well-being goals.